On the 29th of August, the Indian Navy commissioned into service INS Arighat, the second Arihant-class SSBN, ship submersible ballistic nuclear, i.e. nuclear-powered, ballistic missile-carrying submarine. INS Arighat was commissioned into the Indian Navy at the Shipbuilding Center, SBC, at Visakhapatnam in the southern coastal state of Andhra Pradesh. Speaking at the commissioning ceremony, Defense Minister Rajnath Singh stated that Arighat would further strengthen India's three-tier retaliatory nuclear deterrent capability. As per the Ministry of Defense, or MOD, the technological advancements undertaken indigenously on Arighat make it significantly more advanced than its predecessor, Arihant. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why INS Arighat SSBN is India's trump card. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. In December 1971, during the Indo-Pakistani War of 1971, U.S. President Richard Nixon sent a carrier battle group named Task Force 74, led by the nuclear-powered USS Enterprise, into the international waters in the Bay of Bengal in a show of force. In those days, the U.S. was hostile towards India, as India was close to the Soviet Union. In response, the Soviet Union sent a submarine armed with nuclear missiles from Vladivostok to trail the U.S. task force. The Soviet submarine surfaced when the Americans appeared. It was done to demonstrate to them that the Soviet Union had positioned a nuclear submarine in the Indian Ocean, and this prevented any intervention by the U.S. in the ongoing war. The event demonstrated the significance of nuclear weapons and ballistic missile submarines to then-Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. Following the 1974 Smiling Buddha nuclear test, the Indian government ordered a feasibility study for an indigenous nuclear propulsion system. The Indian Navy's Advanced Technology Vessel, or ATV, project to design and construct a nuclear submarine took shape in the 1990s. Nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines are very complex and costly to develop. This is why the US, Russia, UK, France, China, and India are currently the only countries to field a nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarine. Furthermore, integrating SLBMs with them is a major engineering challenge. The new SSBN, INS Arighat, a name that means destroyer of the enemy in Hindi, has the pennant number S3, and it's the second of its kind for India after the INS Arihant, or S2, which was commissioned in August 2016. The submarine displaces around 6,000 tons. It has a length of 365 feet, or 111 meters. It's powered by a single CLWR-B1 compact light water reactor that produces 83 megawatts and drives a single 7-blade propeller. So INS Arighat has unlimited range and endurance limited only by essential supplies. INS Arighat has a maximum speed of 17.5 miles per hour, or 28 kilometers per hour when surfaced, and 27 miles per hour, or 44 kilometers per hour when submerged. It's thought to be able to operate at depths of 1,300 feet, or 350 meters. The submarine is equipped with USHUS, which is an integrated sonar system. It's used for detecting and tracking enemy submarines, surface vessels, and torpedoes, and can be used for underwater communication and avoiding obstacles. The sonar can work in both active and passive mode. The sub also uses Panchendriya Unified Submarine Sonar, control system, and underwater communication system. INS Arighat has six 533mm or 21-inch torpedo tubes, which can be used to carry up to 30 munitions that include torpedoes, missiles, or mines. However, these are intended primarily for self-defense. Ballistic missile submarines are not meant to proactively hunt enemy ships and submarines, but their mission is to lay low and provide the enemy as little a chance as possible to detect them. The key component is the four vertical launch system tubes. While Arihant can carry 12 K-15 Sagarika SLBM or 4 K-4 SLBM, there are unconfirmed reports that INS Arighat is able to carry 8 K-4s or 24 K-15s. K-15 SLBM is a nuke-tipped short-range ballistic missile that has a reported range of around 466 miles or 750 kilometers. The missile is powered by a two-stage solid propellant motor. K-4 is a nuclear-capable intermediate-range submarine-launched ballistic missile. It weighs 17 tons, has a length of 12 meters, and a diameter of 1.3 meters. The missile is solid-fueled and has an accuracy of 20 to 30 meters CEP. K-4 is not MIRV or Multiple Independent Reentry Vehicle enabled as of now. It will carry a single nuclear warhead with a yield equivalent to 200 to 250 kilotons of TNT. To give viewers a perspective, the Little Boy atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima had a yield of 15 kilotons of TNT, and the Fat Man atomic bomb that was detonated over Nagasaki had a yield of 21 kilotons of TNT. K-4 has an estimated range of 2,175 miles or 3,500 kilometers. One can say that K-15 is meant for Pakistan, while K-4 is for China. Nuclear strikes can be carried out from land, air, and sea, and this is known as the nuclear triad. SSBNs are considered to be the most potent weapon delivered by mankind, as they're the most survivable part of the nuclear triad. A surprise preemptive strike might wipe out a country's land-based missiles and nuclear strike aircraft, but it's very difficult to track and take out SSBN patrolling quietly in the depths of the ocean. Since they can't be taken out by first strike and can retaliate against an enemy with SLBMs, no sane adversary will attack a country that possesses a nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarine armed with SLBMs. The importance of these can be gauged from the fact that the 14 ballistic missile submarines of the American Ohio-class SSBNs together carry approximately 50% of the total U.S. active inventory of strategic thermonuclear warheads. SSBN is especially significant for India, as it has no first use of nuclear weapons policy. Earlier, on the 5th of November 2018, while announcing the successful completion of the first deterrence patrol by INS Arihant, India's first SSBN, Prime Minister Narendra Modi stated, "A credible nuclear deterrence is the need of the hour. The success of INS Arihant gives a fitting response to those who indulge in nuclear blackmail." A press release from the PMO further stated that the deployment of the INS Arihant completed the country's survivable nuclear triad. India has plans to build four submarines of the Arihant class, and this fleet will be India's main deterrence, along with nuke-capable aircraft like Rafale and land-based ICBMs like Agni 5. It's interesting to note that India is also working on K-5 and K-6 missiles that will have much longer range, be MIRV-enabled, and will be deployed in a new series of SSBNs.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.